Hello everybody, welcome back to my channel. My name is Ritu and my channel's name is Ritu's Rainbow World. These are my few previous videos and I hope you guys have already loved it. And thank you so much for your love and support.
Hello everybody, welcome back to my channel. My name is Ritu and my channel's name is Ritu's Rainbow World. Now you guys must be wondering why I am looking like this, because right now I have complete no makeup. Now festive season is everywhere around the corner and it's a disheartening that we cannot go to parlors, and specifically I'm not going. My eyebrows are not properly done. I have not done any of the facial or anything on my face, but at the same time festive season is there and I really wanted to get prepped up. My hands are really tanned, by the way. This is the original color of my hand, and the face is a different color, this is a different color. So I really wanted to do some of the DIYs or the facial or anything face pack right at home, because that's the only option we have right now. So without further delay, just quickly get into the video, and before we get into the video, do take a moment, subscribe to my channel, hit the like button and comment down below if there is any kind of suggestions that you will be wanting or you wanted to give me, or you want any video which you want from my side, then definitely I will be doing that. So without further ado, let's just quickly get into the video. And also please take a moment to follow me on Instagram, and my handle will be in the description box, or it will be flashing somewhere over here, which is rituparna_datta_deb, for more updates on what all is happening on my channel. And there's a little update that I have launched a new channel, which is Quirky Styling Tips, and that will be completely on fashion and everything. So it will not be on the random stuffs which I do on this channel, but that will be completely dedicated channel for any kind of look, any kind of beauty tips and all, what all I know. But I am not a pro in makeup and all, but whatever I do, and people do keep on asking me in email, so I thought to make a separate channel on that. So yes, let's just begin with the video. So the first thing is definitely cleaning up your face. So I have done my face wash. I usually use the charcoal face wash from Good Vibes, and also I use the Johnson & Johnson's face wash. So that and Dove, yeah. So these three are the Milk Delight. So these three are the face washes that I usually do, and there is a dedicated video on my favorite face washes, so you can definitely go ahead and check that out as well. Now the first thing which I did is face wash, which I'm completely done. The next thing which I will be doing is massaging of your skin. Now before we do massaging of the skin, it's very important that we scrub the skin. Now this is a video of a DIY which you can do right at home, so you do not need any ingredients which is readily available in the market. So I have taken a little bit of sugar granules and I've sliced one tomato. So first thing is I'll moisturize my skin, because after face wash, little hydration is something which is needed. So this is my DIY. I have made a separate video how to do DIY facial mist at home. So that's the same thing with the aloe vera gel and rose water. So I have actually moisturized my face, and then I'll take the granules and this tomato slice and I'll rub it over my face. Now tomato is something that adds a glow to your skin, and sugar is a natural scrubbing agent that is readily available right at your kitchen. So I'm gonna scrub this really well, and tomato also helps in lightening off your any of the pigmentation on your skin, by the way. So I'll gently rub, because this granules is a little bigger in size, but if you have the sugar granules which is properly grinded, that also you can use it. But right now I am fine, because I need a harsh scrubbing, because I did not scrub for a really long time. Do not do scrubbing under eye area, because that's not the area we do scrubbing by any chance. So please don't do that. So you have to do this for like really 2 to 3 minutes, depending on how much you needed it. Always in the upward direction, don't do any scrubbing or any facial activity in the downward direction. That will lead to the sagging of your skin and will not do good to your skin. Make sure that whatever is in the tomato, the juice part, gets completely done. Now I will do a quick face wash and then I'll move with the next step of the facial. So I have washed off my face really good and I can see a little difference because I think the dead cells are something which is gone. Now the face scrub is okay, but I also do the lip scrub. For that I have made a DIY, which is I've taken a little bit of coffee beans and then I have mixed it with the glycerin. So and I have stored it in the fridge. So somewhere the texture looks like this. So this is what it is. And I also make sure that I always do the lip scrub, just not the face but also the lips. So I'm just gonna use this texture. Coffee is already like little sticky kind of, and that do not you don't need a little good quantity. But take a little quantity and then rub. Now many people, I got a DM that they get a complaint on the pigmentation around the mouth. So even this is good for that. So I'm just gonna rub quickly around the mouth area as well. So coffee, little bit of glycerin and little bit of sugar particles is what this DIY is. So I've done this and I leave it for some time, let that work, and then the next step is definitely your facial massaging, the massage part. So I'm taking this charcoal peel off mask. Now I am just gonna quickly, this is from BioCare and it's something that I have done and I've been using for a very long time. Now this is a peel off mask which is really really very very helpful to remove all your dead particles and anything that is lying over your face. So I'm just gonna quickly apply this. It's a kind of peel off mask, so you can even massage it. It will remove all your unwanted things. And this should be done after the scrub part, because anything which is remaining gunk on the face, it will help to remove even that. Now you have to really massage it and then let it dry, and it will remove all your, if you really wanted to do DIY, you can take a curd, little bit of basin, which is the gram flour, and a little bit of turmeric, and then just make a paste with the help of rose water, and then quickly make a thin, not thin but thick consistency, and then wash it, massage it on your face and then wash it. So that's how you will be able to do the DIY. So I'm just gonna quickly massage and then wash off, and then I'll see you back. So I have completely peeled off, so it is a kind of peel off mask. So there is a lot of difference I can see. So all the gunk and anything which was on the face, that kind of went out. And the last step which I usually do, not the last step but the second last step, is the face pack. Now I'm using the Multani Mitti face pack. Now you can take this as a DIY. So because this is a DIY, so I've taken this from Banjara's. You can take from any random brand, but Multani Mitti is something which is which helps to enhances your complexion, and also at the same time it do cleans your skin from within. If there is any kind of infection or anything on your skin, that clearly it helps to clean out. So it comes in this kind of pouches, and this I'm using for like 3 to 4 years. I've been using this and it have done really an amazing job, because I cannot do anything without Multani Mitti. And you can use Multani Mitti ka paste for a better skin complexion. Now complexion here I mean to clarify your skin, it will not suddenly enhance your complexion. That no cream does that, and I so believe that. So it will help to clear up your skin to a greater extent, and also helps to, you know, enhance your glow on the skin basically. I do not have scissor right now, so I'm just gonna use this. So I'll take a little amount of the powder, and then I'm gonna mix it with the rose water. Now rose water is something which again helps to increase the glow of your skin. So I personally love rose water in all my DIYs or anything that I do at home. So I am taking little bit of the rose water and the aloe vera gel, and then I'm gonna make a smooth paste out of it. Now multani mitti is something which is a holy grail if you are looking for a flawless skin. Now in the college days I did not have an access to a lot of this cosmetics and all of that, because I was never that kind of person. So I think multani mitti was something that did great to my skin and that I still follow religiously. So the paste will somewhere look like this, and you're just gonna apply it all over your face, let it dry, and then wash off with water, and I think the skin will look flawless. Trust me. I'm just gonna apply it all over my face area, also in your neck part. This also you can use on your tan hands, which I'm gonna apply because my hands are really tanned. Then on your forehead. But trust me, multani mitti, I can't rave enough about it, but it is honestly the best thing ever was discovered in terms of cosmetics and all of this makeup field, because I think nothing can replace multani mitti. It is so good. Next, my hands really tan, so I'm just gonna apply it also on my hands. It helps to remove the tan as well, by the way, guys. So I'm just gonna apply a thin layer of it, and make sure that once you are done with washing and drying off it, do moisturize, because I think multani mitti is something which will make your skin a little dry, in the sense it takes off the dead cells on your skin. So that's the reason it really dehydrates your skin, I can say that. So I'll just apply it everywhere, wherever I feel there is a tan, and I'll let it dry, and then I quickly wash off, and then we will move to the last step. I washed off my face. I can see a real good difference in my face. So that's how clear the face is. By the way, I have absolute no makeup. So there is a no camera trick which is running over here. But this is my honest thing, because I'm sorry. The multani mitti and the scrubbing, the natural scrub that we do with the help of tomato and sugar, is something that really, really works out great for, I think, every skin type. Now, this skin facial is for all the skin types, so everybody, can go ahead and use this one. Now, the best thing which I was telling about the multani mitti is it completely cleans out all the gunks. Now, being a YouTuber, I have to wear makeup like every now and then when I come in front of camera, so that is something which is also not very good for the healthy skin. But again, makeup is something which is very essential nowadays, and we usually do it, so it's very important that whatever gunk, or if you go out of office, I know you guys are working from home, but sometimes you go out and there is a lot of things which is going on. You go out for any essential things, your skin takes up all the dirt and everything from outside. So it's very important that you use the multani mitti. I highly recommend, this is from Banjara's. You can take any random company, you can take Habs Goodness, Good Vibes, multani mitti. But what I wanted to say is multani mitti is something which should be used once or twice in a week to remove all the gunk, and also to enhance your complexion. By the way, that is something which is very important. Now we have done all the process of three steps for the glowing skin. Now the next thing which I will do is hydrate. It's very important to hydrate your face because that's how your skin will rejuvenate. For hydration, I am using the Saffron Nourishing Day Cream. Now this is the day cream which I love and it is my holy grail ever since I got it. I've already finished halfway through and I've already finished the one tub of it. So it is my second tub and I'm gonna moisturize my face including the eye area. I always use it under the eyes, so I think I do not use any of the under eye cream because I think this does the job to a greater extent. So I'm just gonna moisturize my face, also the neck area because here also. And that's pretty much, guys. So this is the last step, so you can get easily glowing skin sitting right at home with the kitchen ingredients. So scrubbing pot I've shown for the pack. You can use curd, basin, which is the gram flour, little bit of turmeric, and then little bit of lime juice. Depends if your skin is sensitive, do not go for the lime juice. So curd, basin, and little bit of turmeric is enough for the face pack. For the scrub, tomato and the sugar particles, and definitely for the pack you can use multani mitti. So these are the very three simple ingredients which is right available in your kitchen and readily available anywhere, like multani mitti, to get your glowing skin. Trust me, I can feel a lot of difference after doing this. There is a lot of change which I have felt it on my face ever since I've been following all these three steps. So I hope this video is a little helpful. If yes, do take a moment to subscribe to my channel, hit the like button, comment, and do follow me on Instagram and Facebook for more such updates, and I will see you in the next video. Bye for now.